to race. It's going to be the 1G, the Warrior House car, the Comanche chassis of Ron King. Don't forget, he's got his booth set up, selling his souvenir t-shirts, the 1G of Ron King. We're going to go to the green flag, Crosville Speedway, after an amazing Southern Nationals race. We're going to go steelhead late model racing when we come out of turn number 4. Race fans, we're going to go 25 laps steelhead late model racing. We're underway. Off into one corner hedge car. He's over driving. Cavani keeps it back together. We're going to remain green flag. He's going to drop way back. Something's wrong with that car. Caution out. Caution flag is out. Caution flag out. The people are out in front of the booth. You need to move.
Speedway videos.
We're to the green flag. Corey Hitchcock's going to jump out front on lap number 1, followed by Ron King. Chase King's going to move to the bottom side of the number 3 spot. Chase King all over the rear end of the 1G Warrior chassis. Corey Hitchcock in the 23 is going to take lap number 1. Ron King in second. Josh Rennie signs up the racetrack, but he's going to get a run coming out of turn number 2. He's going to move to the number 3 spot, putting Chase King in fourth. So Corey Hitchcock, Lyle, Tennessee driver, is going to take lap number 2 as well. So they're battling out for the number 3 spot. Josh Henry working the top side. Chase King in the middle of the racetrack. Josh Henry going to take the number 3 spot on lap number 4-3. So Corey Hitchcock still leading the way out front. Then Ron King in second. Josh Henry in third. Chase King in fourth. Deal in fifth. That's your top 5 cars with 4 laps complete. 21 more to go around Crosville Speedway. Corey Hitchcock's moving to the top side. Down into 1 and 2. Ron King's moved down to the bottom in the 1G, inching closer and closer to the Lyle, Tennessee driver in the 23, the Rocket chassis Eagle Racing engine of Corey Hitchcock. He pulls up next to his door coming out of turn number 2. Corey Hitchcock gets a run. He knows he's got to drop down to the bottom side to throw a block on Ron King. 19 laps of racing left around Crosville Speedway. Corey Hitchcock's led every single lap. Josh Henry in third, Ron King in second. Seven laps complete. Corey Hitchcock leads away. He's moved off the top side down to the bottom side. Ron King working the bottom side. Josh Henry's up on the top side at 1 and 2. He's going to go to the top side at 3 and 4. Crosville Speedway's looking great tonight. The guy's done a great job with the racetrack. Multiple grooves of racing going on here. Corey Hitchcock found some speed down on the bottom. Ron King was catching up with him. And then now Corey Hitchcock moved down to the bottom to throw the block, and he's faster on the bottom. So we're going to be 9 laps complete. Corey Hitchcock moves almost to the middle of the racetrack. Josh Henry still banging the cushion around the racetrack here at Crosville Speedway. This is going to be 10 laps complete this time around. 15 more to go. 15 more laps of racing. Look at Drew Kennedy. He is on a move. He's already moved up to the top 8. Moving to the number 7 spot right in front of Perry Delaney. But the battle's on. Josh Henry, Chase King as we come out of 4th. Chase King is going to take the number 3 spot away from Josh Henry. Josh Henry moves down to the bottom of the racetrack. So Corey Hitchcock moves back up to the top of the racetrack, down in 3 and 4. Ron King still working the bottom side. Chase King gets around Josh Henry last lap. Now he's on the number 3 spot. Now he's got to make up some room on your leaders. Drew Kennedy working the bottom side of the racetrack. Almost got a run on the 23 of Lane Clifton. Ron King has moved back to the left quarter panel of Corey Hitchcock, down into 1 and 2. Perry Delaney in the 77 pulls in. His night comes to an end. Tough luck to the driver out of Sparta, Tennessee in the 77 of Perry Delaney. So right here, we're going to have 10 laps of racing left. Corey Hitchcock leading the way, followed by Ron King, then Chase King. Then you've got Josh Henry, then the battle is on for the number 5 spot. Dill and Clifton battling it out. The 23 of Lane Clifton's gonna take that spot. Drew Kennedy down to the bottom side. He's gonna try to get around Dill out of turn number 4. He's gonna remain in his spot. So you've got two cars on the bottom side. Chase King banging the top side in the third spot, gaining some ground on your front two cars. Chase King, he's got a little bit of time left to make up. He's starting to catch up with the front two cars. Chase King is going to make a run on them. Corey Hedgecock down on the bottom side, still catfishing for moisture. Ryan King down there as well on the front end sidewall. Chase King on the top side, Josh Henry on the top side as well. This is going to be 19 laps complete. 19 complete, six more to go. Corey Hedgecock runs up on the back of Carterman. They're going to put Carterman a lap down out of turn two. Ryan King, Carterman door to door. He puts him a lap down. Chase King's going to move to the top side. Carterman's going to get in his way. Is he going to get around him or is he going to hold him up? He's going to hold him up down the front straightaway, but King gets around him. Moves to the middle of the racetrack, hits a bump. Looky here, Ryan King trying to make a move on the inside of Corey Hedgecock. He's going to stick his nose up next to his number when we come out of turn number four. With just four laps of racing left, we've got a race on our hands for the leader. Corey Hedgecock can hear Ryan King in the 1G right beside him. He's going to go down on the racetrack as far as he can. He knows that White Warrior chassis is all over him. Three laps left. Chase King's moved down to the bottom side of the racetrack. They come out of four. Corey Hedgecock leads the way. 23 laps complete. Two more to go. We're going to crown a $1,000 winner. Ryan King's starting to get a run out of two. Starting to sneak up next to the door of the 23 of Corey Hedgecock. White flag in the air for Corey Hedgecock. So they come out of two. If Ryan King's going to do something, he's got to do it here. Corey Hedgecock makes some room on him down the back straightaway. King's going to throw it in hard into four, but taking the checkered flag. It's going to be from Loudoun, Tennessee, Corey Hedgecock. Ryan King in second, Chase King in third, Josh Henry fourth. Lane Clifton's going to be number five. What a race we had there for the Steelhead Late Model feature. Corey Hedgecock, Ryan King, put a show on for you in the Steelhead Late Models. Race fans, make some noise for the Loudoun, Tennessee driver, Mr. Corey Hedgecock.